Hello, welcome back to episode 5. Let's get into the game. There we go, this one. Alright, in this episode, I'm gonna finish the mall and then expand to military science, but before that, I believe what I need to do is, if I remember where I left off, we were researching cars, so we can go out and claim some territory from the biters. Give them a taste of freedom. Actually, I will work on this a little bit before I go do that, so these can work and stock up while I'm away. I think that's a good planning decision. Done everything up to that point? Okay. Seeing if there's anything I missed down here. Looks like there still is. If you hold Q over a ghost, in case anyone's wondering what I'm doing, you can hold Q over a ghost, or just push Q by default, the default key, and whatever item is there, if it's an inserter or a power pole or anything else, it'll auto-select that unit in that position. Also, you can hold Q on an item that you already have, and then you'll get... You can then place that item. Like that. What's a good example? Or you could hold Shift, and then you see that little icon. And then you can create a ghost from an item that you've already placed. Q, Shift, place, or Q, Shift. Interesting little trick, in case anyone's newer to the game and doesn't know. I'll put these... I messed up there. There we go. Alright, let's finish this out. Finish placing these. 46 and 22 are the amount of inserters I have left. Gonna be a lot in, out. Here's another one of these. There's another one of those. It can be hard to see these sometime. Okay. I added a little gain to my mic. I think I want to sound louder, so I can come across more clearly. That is red circuits. These are substations. This is going to be a substation. Little addition. There's currently no lane for red circuits to come on. Everything's already a split bell. I could add them. Get started making steel chests. Wow, I made 50 of those. I gotta put half of them back. Nice. Start picking up some of this stuff. Yep. All right. Aha, see, I missed something. Where is this landing? In there, okay. Can I build more grenades? No. Those are circuit conditions, circuit wires. Okay. I like how I like kind of know what's happening. Yes. Okay, let's place down the new blueprint and update the recipes. Transport belts in the way. Oh, yeah, because some of this changed down here. Okay. Okay, that's why that recipe didn't take. I didn't... Oh, I placed them down wrong. Okay. I feel better. Thought I messed something up very badly for a second. Let's walk up here. That's fine, yeah. That's why I don't have these in the blueprint. So I don't want them sucking everything up. All the resources from the base for a while. Wow, that's kind of a lot to start out with. Although I kind of know why I have it so high, the limit set so high from those boxes. It's because how do I say this? Let me think of. It's because when I transition to the next base, I want a lot of red belts, a lot of red undergrounds, and a lot of red splitters, because the new base is going to be mostly red belts. But I don't need to be building those yet. As we can see, there's still plenty of things that aren't even being made yet. That's been all put in here. This makes those. Some of the oil refineries are going to get done. Waiting on pipes, you're making pipes. Alright. Make some more of those. What else could I be using? This base does not make the default ammo. But we should be okay. I should download a mod. Shows time in game and biter evolution. Should be a go-to one. I'm gonna put my car over here. And let's go. Right. 50 should be fine. Let's go spread some democracy. Democracy and freedom. Here we go. When clearing out bases, some of the biggest factors in evolution are the actual spawners. Killing those bumps up pollution, I mean, bumps up biter evolution a lot. I can already see some of the stage 2 biters, so spitters, I think, are not, small spitters are not far behind. Those two that we just deleted are like the different looking ones. Oops. Repair. That was fast. I think I need, to just pick up some coal and iron. So I'm trying not to kill more than I need to. I'm trying to just kill the spawners. I'm gonna leave those for now and we can come back and clear those later. Kill those worms later. Let's go pick up some coal. Oops. I need iron too, so I'm gonna pick up some of that as well. Can make the armor piercing ammo, but I don't really feel the need. Grenades are more important, yeah. Pick up some of that. What am I out of? Oh, already, only 20, huh? I'll be making more grenades as time goes. As time goes on, this will be good. Efficient. Your car can damage biters. Not really good at running over anything. Even the small ones can take a little bit of time. When the spitters start spawning, you can't really just sit in your vehicle and tank it. The car just doesn't have enough HP. Uranium! Oh, that's great. I'll keep working on this. Okay. Kinda dark outside. I mean, in the game. That uranium is so much closer than my last game. Hello, base. Oh, I haven't researched rails yet. When I get back, I'm gonna work on... Yeah, we should get those. And then that, absolutely, that's the next step. Eight more grenades. Okay. In production queue. Whoop. Yeah, zoom so far out I can't see the rocks. But then, oh no. Oh gosh. Okay. Another tip. You want to use turrets and vehicle weapon when possible, because they will get two bonuses. The ammo gets a damage bonus when you research these types of damage bonuses. Damage bonus and then shooting speed bonus. The vehicle also gets the same damage bonus, whereas you as a person shooting your gun only gets the one bonus. And that's why vehicles and stuff, vehicles and turrets get more. here's the hot little button for seeing all your damage bonuses. As you can see, your turrets get a damage bonus, and then your magazines also get another damage bonus. They actually get two. Don't feel like... How far have we gone? Oh, buddy. Oh, look, another base. Oh, look, another base. And this fuel really saves me. This is an expander base. That did not spawn at the start of the game. Another one. Oop. I wish I could make more grenades. That's a pretty big area. Still no iron. That little 1.3 doesn't count. Hello there. Maybe there's not a lot of iron in the desert. I don't know if certain biomes have different base chances. Wow, it's a whole day has gone by and my lights are turning on again for their vehicle. There we go. That's what I want to see. So this is going to get cleared out then. Oh gosh. I didn't realize how low I was getting. Base. Zoom in to navigate around those rocks. Hello, autosave. That's a nice oil patch. I might ping this. Is that the right word? Ping? Yeah. No, tag it. Woo! 3 times higher than anything that was in my last game. And there's no way that 33% increase helped that much. Especially when my first oil field that I found was a little bit farther away than this and 500. 560. That map was awful. How much fuel have I gone through? 7. I might aggro these guys. In fact, I do. Hit a rock. Ooh, my car's almost dead. Don't hit any more rocks. Oh, gosh. Three? So what I'm trying to do, don't aggro, is I want to go around this, and then I'm going to scout above, and then I'll go back to the base. I'm pretty much going to wall this area over here. There's nothing useful over here. It's a desert biome. I don't really want to be in the desert biome. Probably going to build more up in this area. It's a very nice iron. It's another nice iron. I think my last map was just really, really unlucky. Because if I were to subtract 33% from some of these patches that I'm seeing, I'd still be very happy with them. But the last game that I played, I might load it just to show you guys. The iron patches are like 2 million tops, and these are like 7. 1 uranium, like 1 million miles away from my base. Really bad oil fields. It was awful. Where is a hole? Is this a hole? My grenades are precious. I don't want to use them to blow down the trees. That's a base I can get rid of. Probably just use the normal ammo and not waste my grenade, even if it is faster to just nade. Oh, that's a base. And it's closer to me. Another uranium! I need my grenades for this base. I totally messed that up. I should have just kept on shooting the spawner. I can't build another one. That's unfortunate. I think I'll build another car. I will need rails. Rails and rail signals. Probably more research speed. Maybe more items for the mall to build. I'm not exactly pressured for oil, because I still need to build the military science, and then I need to build the oil refinery, and then I need to get the oil refining outpost up and running. Okay. And look at all that. So what am I missing for a car? Just iron. Okay. These are pretty much done. I can get rid of these. That's fine. Yeah. Look at that. Look how great that is. It's so great. Oh. Luxury. I can even pick up some lights. This is fantastic. I'm loving this. Yeah, that's fine. I love how this kind of like recycles these older furnaces. 100, 100. Don't need those in my inventory yet. Don't need those in my inventory yet. Why aren't you building? Missing gears. Forgotten inserter. Forgotten inserter. Forgotten inserter. That's those, right? I'm pretty sure that's what that is. Look at that. Trains. Engines will go in here. Flamethrower goes here. Can't build that yet. That's correct. Ah, yes. Another big item, I think, goes in here. Oh, rails are being built. Okay, that's good. Train stations, right, that's down here. Okay. Engines. Oof, that's going to take a while to craft. It's okay. Lights. Fantastic. Let's wait for the rail signals to be done. They do block you from walking. Okay. Two more. Wait for that to build, and then build the last one. There we go. Placing that down so I kind of don't have to look at it anymore. Is there a stack of these? No, but I could bump that. I could bump my science up. So normally, well, these are both producing the same amount of science. So say I look at this, 0.75 science a second, it's 45 science a minute on the blue machine, 30 science a minute on the gray machine. You see these will consuming science at 38 science per minute. And this is producing 45 science. So even these labs aren't enough. Now we're researching lab speed, which is going to make them research faster. So eventually, it won't actually be able to keep up. This one can be fast. That one also probably needs to be fast. And then some of these guys can be fast. Now, as well as these machines crafting faster, they also, they take more electricity. However, they actually produce less pollution. So this has a pollution of 3, you see on the right-hand side on that little UI that pops up and goes away. Crafting speed, 0.75. Pollution, 3. I think it's 3 per minute, not 3 meters. And then if you look at an older machine, it says pollution 4. Pollution 4, half crafting speed, pollution 0.5. Three pollution. Alright. Let's go to base builder 2. Things are going to start to move quicker and quicker until I need to outpost. Well, now that we have a good automation base, things are going to start to pick up until I need to outpost the oil, and then things will slow down. Let's see. I'm still using the power pole, the wooden power poles. Definitely in the future, if I were to update this blueprint, I would definitely replace these with the steel ones at this point, because that's what the base makes. The base makes the steel ones. Let there be light. Fantastic. Whoops, there we go. Whoop. I don't have the assembler 2 machines. I very unwisely used them all. Yes, more inputs. And I think I will abide by this. Rather than siphon them off here and put them in, I think I'm gonna make more iron and copper and steel production. So if I run out of stuff here, I know there's still plenty of inserters for me to grab, so I can use I can build as much of this as possible now and still have enough for what I need to grab for more smelting and mining. Oh, I would have done that. Should have done that a little bit differently. I would have input output like this rather than having an input here and then the input down here. If I were to do it again, that's what I would do. And I know why it's like that, because in my original design, when I originally did this and then I went to test it, I realized I didn't put an output. I was like, why isn't it outputting any science? I was like, oh yeah, they need more inserters. Just take them all. Oh yeah, those are back again. Wait, what? That is certainly confusing. I didn't realize that I had another car. Chemical science, okay. Let's unlock more things for the mall. Circuit networks are going to be a deal. More space is always nice. Concrete is going to be needed as well. All right. Now the annoying thing that's not on the base already is the coal. It's only used for a couple of things. Let's get rid of these two from my hotbar in place. Those and those. 300. We're gonna go through them. Promise. All right. We're gonna double what we smelt here. Gone from 7.5 to. Is it because not all of them are working? What the heck? Yeah, the iron's not making it all the way down. Okay. I should say the iron ore is not making it all the way down. Oh my. Iron is a lot more precarious than I thought. $400,000. What's my pollution cloud? And this is in the middle of what I want again. Take a closer look at that. Train's gonna come out over here. Or across here. No, I'm not ready to build that much landfill. Ah, oops. I totally forgot about this. That could also help. Hull doesn't even need to barely be expanded. Yeah, I don't even want to. I will just add another row so it's here. Good. Okay. Leave my car out. I did leave my car out. Oh, imagine that. And I just picked it up. I'm a special person. Okay. Am I missing? I am missing. Whatchamacallit? The orange stuff. This stuff. It's interesting, right? Boilers require copper because of the small electric motor. Why don't I make more than that? Just deal with it now. Sorry, I think I might have been mumbling. There we go. I'll try and speak more clearly in case I haven't been. One, two, three, four, five, six. Now it's iron. Okay. I still have burners? Good. That was an interesting looking palm tree. I think it was dead. Need more iron. That's a lot of copper. Three. Four. Five, six, seven, eight. How many boilers is this? 14. So I can build 6 more. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. This will produce 36 megawatts of steam power. And that is all a single pump can support. This base will run about 40 to 50 megawatts. Did I miscount? Or 8, 12 more. Doesn't need to be moved, but these do. Do I want to bring it down from below? Yeah, might as well. Works for me. Okay, does this jump into the middle? It does. So I want this one to be jump over all of these, actually. Oh. M, not N. All is this guy. Behold the power of radar. Alright, let's get more belts. ...186 miners. Should be fine. Oh, there's stone here. Let's use it. Is this a meteorite? Nope. Little bit of iron there. I'm not sure I'm gonna be able to. To mine it though, I'm not sure I'm gonna be able to mine it. Should give me enough room. I'm gonna make stone bricks here, and that's all I need, right? Yeah. Probably just shut off base power to the base. But it's fine. So I'm going to build. There we go. And now this can go here. And there, and there. Oop. This. Huh. There we go. That was a mistake on my part. Okay. Wait a minute. I need fuel. What have I done? Build a straight up stone. No, this one. I forget how much this. I forget how much walls take a second. One, two. Oh. Let's just get these ready for construction. Then research more lab speed. Point 0.75. So half of one of these. Can this actually just supply? That it probably can. Whatever. That's as far as that goes, because I don't feel like sorting it yet. Although I probably will start sorting the iron here real soon, because I really don't have any close by. Like that, bring that into here, go like this. Okay. Probably could have just done those three down there. I didn't need to do what I did. Kind of redundant. Let's see if this is enough. If that single smelting stack is enough. I actually think it should be. That single smelting stack of stone bricks. Which means I just need to do some finagling of peeling it off. Bringing it over there. And then I think, well, let's see, we're going on an hour. No stone bricks for over here yet, but let's start building these. There's no iron for more steel. So maybe I just jank it up. Do something like this. Copper is the one going on top, though. Spaghetti. I love me some spaghetti. Let's get bricks over here. The worst part is, once this base becomes spaghetti, I'll probably never change it because it's not worth changing. Oh, hold on. Stone bricks gets used for other things, so I will need to make another stone smelting thing. Other stone smelting array. That can go there. Can't drive a car down there, but I can walk down there. All the boxes are in the way. Storage boxes. I can come down here and start making these guys. What else is new? I'm actually not exactly sure where my train stations were. This takes glass or concrete. Single stack. These are probably red and green wire, which I guess I still haven't researched yet. No, I have. There they are. If I had to guess, this is where the train station is. Let's take green circuits. I'm not sure. Guess I stamp it down again. Yeah, okay, they're still blank. Concrete, this is big telephone poles. The iron sticks are needed for the train station. Oh, hold on. If it's a Mark II assembler, does it not pick up the recipe? That would be weird. Either way, I guess it's time to stretch iron out. Man, I had a good full 5 minutes of good iron, and now I'm back to not having good iron. I'm actually not even going to research that to save resources right now. Okay, train stations and then the copper wire. There we go. What did I put in here? Oh, I put this guy up one. oh well. There we go. Get rid of resources. Here's another 50 of those. Bunch of those. Get a bunch of those. Okay. Still need to get this up and running. That didn't come through, because I forgot that. Why don't I just do that? Seems like a good idea. Now, when this is going full blast, it's not it's gonna be half about exactly. Oh, I haven't researched inserter. I need to research filter inserter, and then I can do the stack inserter, which is behind other stuff. Okay. Inserter stack size is still a ways off, and until these start carrying two items, which effectively doubles their transporting capacity, this is only going to take 3 a second. So this can't even work at full blast. Okay. And these are 10 seconds. And just got its second one. These guys are full. They're not taking anymore. Okay. Alright. Iron's low. Well, that old patch just died off. Gosh. Do I take the car out again with no grenades? Let's get grenades. Let's start automating this stuff. This will be a quarter of a belt if it was full, which it's not. That's going to automate grenades. Our copper is actually good and will continue to be good for some time. I believe this one's copper. That went rather quickly. We need to start down the plastic line. Is there anything else important here? Suppose flammables for when I build an outpost. Yeah, I get that. Yep. Okay. Okay, so while that's working, we're low on resources, I'll limit it to that right now. I build grenades. If I steal the coal, I can. More coal, huh? Okay. Curious, I'm just gonna do this. Just a little power grid comb. It makes the power lines look more neat. Northwest. It's this direction. There it is. That is. This is west. West and east. Okay. Got 11 grenades. That looks like a new base that wasn't there a little while ago. Yep, that was the right choice. Nice. Okay. Is there any iron closer? That's really what I'm looking for. Otherwise, I think it's going to be train time already. Single line rail. Ooh, there's an oil patch here. I slid by those. There's a lot of oil here. I wonder if the resources that a planet spawns with are random generated. I might as well spend some time to check over there. Oh my, it connects. Not a peninsula. At least, maybe not. Oh man. There's a biter base there. What is that resource? Is that a resource? No, okay. Looks like one. A rock in the middle of the nowhere. Mm-hmm. going into a biome that I don't like. Hey, that's iron. That wouldn't be bad to train over. Let's see what's around it. It is hard to see in the dark. Oh man. Driving skills I am not known for. And that seems like a lot of... Wow, there's... There's so many resources on this planet. Still can't get over it. Still amazed. I'm still flabbergasted. Look at that. They're all next to each other, too. I can even smelt it over here. I'll just have to clear those biters. Oh, man. This is such a difference than my other planet. I still can't get over that. Really weird shapes here, though. But I think that's part of the mod. Unlike the base game. Alright, 9 grenades. Let's see what I can do. Yeah, that's the space bar. Oh, shit. Oh no, that's embarrassing. Backup plan. Well, there goes another 200 rounds of ammo. I'm actually going to take some out. Alright, don't mess up again. It's a lot of big worms. That is a rock. Yeah, okay. I'm not gonna be able to do this. Not without a lot of grenades. Which I don't think I'm making a lot of grenades. So why don't I start outposting out? I think I'll end the episode. Outposting out to the iron. We'll build our first outpost next episode. And then we're good on all the other resources. Really. For a while. So... probably do a double outpost. Get the oil, try and get oil up and running. Almost done with the plastics. And then it's the sulfur, the sulfuric acid, the lubricant. Actually, that comes after Blue Science. That's being made. Yeah, that's totally fine. Alright, and with that, I will see you guys next time.